नमस्ते चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम बैक टू सोशल क्लास। डियर चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू आर ऑल वेरी ग्रेट एट योर होम। डियर चिल्ड्रेन, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव सीन ओनली द रोडवेज। इन टुडेस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द रेलवेज एंड वाटरवेज। ओके, लेट्स मूव अहेड। रेल ट्रांसपोर्ट। Railways are the cheapest mode of transportation for carrying people, heavy goods over long distance. So railways are the very cheapest. So it's a very low cost transportation for carrying people as well as heavy goods over a long distances. Advanced technology has enabled laying of railway lines in the terrain, hill and the deserts, difficult to reach. So terrain means the type of land. So advanced technologies enable laying of railway lines. So it is very difficult to put the lay the railway lines for a hill stations and the desert areas. Invention of diesel and electric engine has largely replaced the steam engine that has helped to reduce air pollution. So when the steam engine produced the more air pollution, after the invention of diesel and electric engine, it is replaced the steam engine to reduce the air pollution. Nowadays, super bullet trains are in use all over the world, which have made our journey very faster. So nowadays, the super bullet trains are available in many countries like Japan, Germany, so on. It made our journey very faster. Then, in most countries, trains are most important means of transport for people and goods. They can efficiently move a large number of people over a long distances. They are also very useful for moving bulky goods from one place to another. So, in most of the countries, trains are very, very important means of transport because it is a very cheapest means of transport, no? So that is why it is a very important transport for all the countries, more or less more countries, and then for people and also for goods. They can efficiently, systematically move a large number of people over a long distance. So they can carry, the train carries a more large number of people and also goods to one place to another. They are also very useful for moving a bulky goods, that is heavy goods, from one place to another. In India, the first railway train ran between the Bombay and Bombay means now we are calling as a Mumbai and Thane, about 150 years ago in 1853. So in 1853, the first railway train ran between a Bombay and Mumbai to Thane. So about in 150 years before. India has one of the largest railway network in Asia. So in Asian continent, India is the one of the largest railway networks and the fourth largest in the world also. The Shatabdi and Rajdhani trains have a peak speed of over 100 kilometers per hour. So in India, Shatabdi and Rajdhani trains have in India it runs over 100 kilometers per hour. Then, the railway networks in Europe and North America are very well developed and the trains are faster than in India. Japan, France and Germany have trains running at over 300 kilometers an hour. Train running between England and France go through the Channel Tunnel. The tunnel is 40 meters below the seabed under the water of the English Channel. So the railway networks in Europe, so Europe and North America are very well developed. So in Europe and North America, when we compare to India, Europe and North America are very well developed in railway transport and the trains are very faster than India. So in India, the speedest train runs over only the 100 kilometers per hour, but in those countries it runs over 300 kilometers per hour. What are the countries? Japan and France and Germany. Then trains running between the England and France go through the Channel Tunnel. Okay, so the train between the England and France, so it go through only the channel tunnel. The tunnel is 40 meters below. The tunnel is about the meters of 40. And then seabed under the water. So it is a seabed. It runs through the seabed under the water of English Channel. Okay children, let's move on to the waterways. See, the history of transportation on water goes back thousands of years. Because water is the one thing that mankind needs to survive civilization have always been settled near and around the water. Historically, societies have always located near water due partly to the fact that water enables more efficient travel compared to going over land. So in civilization, all the people in those days, that in early people, they always locate near the water. So water transport is very, very efficient in those days. And waterways are critically important to the transportations of people and goods throughout the world. So waterways are a very critically important, very significant important for a transportation for the peoples and goods throughout the world. The complex network for connection between the coastal plain, coastal ports, inland ports, rail, air and truck routes forms the foundations of material economic wealth worldwide. Then, the early people made a raft to carry goods. So, that is a raft means is a type of boat. They were soon replaced with the boats. Then began the sailboats, which used the power of the wind to move. With the invention of the steam engine, the water transport is also underwent a revolution. About 200 years ago, the ships driven by the steam engine started replacing sailboats. The ship became a larger and faster. Today, most ships are driven by the diesel engine. So, in early people, they used to travel in the sea or a water by raft. And slowly, gradually, they replaced into boats. And then, in the boats became a sailboats, which used to travel. So, with the power of wind to move. With the invention of the steam engine, the water transport is also underwent after the invention of steam engine, the water transport underwent a great revolution. About 200 years ago, the ship driven by the steam engine started replacing the sailboat. So after the 200 years ago, the ship driven by the steam engine and it started replacing the sailboat also. The ship became a larger and faster. So after the invention of the steam engine, the ship are made by the very larger and faster too. So today the most ships are driven by the diesel engines. Most bulky goods such as food grains, mineral ores and petroleum are transported around the world by ships. So most bulky goods, the heavy goods such as food grains, that is the cereals, mineral ore, that is the valuable metals and petroleum are transported around the world by ships. So it is transported around the world by or through ships. Though ships are not very fast, a single ship can carry as much cargo as thousands of trucks or aircraft. So, though the ships are not very fast like a aeroplane or some road-based vehicles, but it can be carry as much as cargo. As much of cargo means what? So, as much of goods, that is a thousands of trucks by ship, through the ship and also aircraft. Today, most ships that carry only one type of goods, for example, food grains or petroleum. Today, the most ships can carry only one type of goods, like cereals or petroleum. Then, transport by ship is also much cheaper than the road or air transport. So the shipways, that is the waterways, is very much cheaper than when we compare to roadways or airways. To make a sea travel easier and faster, the canal linking seas have been dug. So children, what is the meaning of canal? A deep cut that is made through land so that a boat or ship can travel along it. So the water can flow to an area where it is needed. That is a canal. So for making the ship to travel easier and faster, they are have been dug canals to linking a countries. So they cut down the travel distance between almost fast. So the Suez Canal links the Mediterranean Sea with the Red Sea. Ships from India traveling to Europe now go through this canal. They no longer have to go around Africa to reach Europe. Next, let's see about the Panama Canal. The Panama Canal links the Pacific Ocean with the Atlantic Ocean. Ships going from Europe to Australia now go through the canal. So which canal? Panama Canal. Earlier, they had to go around the South America. India is surrounded by seas on three sides. Dear children, we know that India is surrounded by three sides of seas. So what are they? So Pacific Ocean, Bay of Bengal and Indian Ocean. So it's a long coastal, it has a long coastal line, has a number of ports such as Mumbai, Chennai, Kolkata, Visakhapatnam, Kochi and Mamajo. So these are the ports. A major portion of goods exported from India and imported into India. So through the port, they are exported and imported the goods from India to other countries. So by ships. Within India, several rivers such as Brahmaputra and Ganga are used as a waterways. So through the waterways, they are using to transport the goods from one place to another. Dear children, hope you enjoy the voyage. We will meet in a next class with the interesting topic, airways. Thank you.